We got this from Gary Reeves at the Indiana Queen Breeders yearly meeting, and he says he's been using it for several years, and he said that's all he uses. He has no mite problems whatsoever. You use 17 ounces by weight on the food grade glycerin and 17 ounces by weight of the oxalic acid.
Where do you get your glycerin?
We just ordered it from Amazon.
Yeah.
And it's definitely cheaper. Everyone uses all of it probably, but it's cheaper to buy it by the gallon.
Oxalic acid is powdered?
Yes.
And you use 17 ounces?
17 ounces by weight.
And a half.
How does the glycerin come?
Pardon?
How does the glycerin come?
Liquid, right?
All liquid.
It's all liquid, but they pack that and it comes. Okay.
It's just a blue shop that you can get Walmart or anywhere, cut in half. You mix your oxalic and your glycerin into whatever container you're going to use. You heat it to 160 degrees. And once it hits 160, so he used a crock, they just set them, both rolls down in there, and you have to hold them down. You want to use rubber gloves and probably safety glasses.
How about breathing protection?
No. He said the only time you're going to run into a problem is if you let that get too hot, and once it hits 170 degrees, then that's when it vaporizes.
Yeah, I know it can cause kidney issues.
But
heat the water first before you put the towels in?
Well, you don't put any, there's no water.
There's no water. The mixture.
Heat your mixture first.
Heat your mixture to 160.
Before you put the towels in.
So once you get it to 160, set both in there, and you'll have to hold them down until it starts to soak that up. And then you'll let it soak up to where you can see it come up halfway. And then once it does that, you'll just take and turn it over and hold it down again until it's completely saturated. And then what they were doing was they pull off, see, how was he doing that, four sections. They would just take and fold it.
That's wet now, right?
Yeah, you definitely want to have your gloves on. Just fold it over, over again, put it in a Ziploc bag, do it up.
And then it takes just one of these per
Ziploc.
Oh, that's to store it.
To store it, yeah.
Yeah. Now, when you're putting it in the hive, you put it in all boxes?
No.
Just one?
Just the box between your first and second box.
Okay.
And I talked to him on the way down here because I couldn't remember if he said he unfolded it or not. He said, crack your boxes open, lay it in there, set your box back down. And it's not a fast knockdown. It's a long-term, slow release. And how long did he say he left some of his in there?
I would say four months.
Like 4 to 5 months.
Okay.
And he said that he's went out and cracked the boxes open and looked, and they're still damp after that amount of time.
Really?
When do you do this?
Anytime.
Including Super Speed on?
Super's on and everything.
So the bees do not chew on it?
He said that they will very seldom ever chew any of it.
Okay.
What's the shelf life? Once you put it in your little Ziploc bag, you have more than you need. How long are those good to?
As long as the towels are still moist, it's still good.